Most of us give little to no consideration as to how the numbers we use every day of our lives came to be. Did they spontaneously pop into existence? Have they always existed? Of course, the answer is much more complex and interesting. These numbers, often called Hindu-Arabic numerals, or simply Arabic numerals, as the name suggests, do not come from Europe, as many of you might have assumed. So, just how did the Europeans, and by extension most of the world, come to use today what we simply know as the numbers? Our story begins in the 3rd century BCE, in the Mauryan Empire, its current ruler Ashoka wanting to spread his edicts throughout his entire realm. As such, he raises a series of pillars throughout his domain containing these edicts. These edicts would be written in many different languages and different writing scripts. One of these would be called the Brahmi script, which had its own numerical system, the Brahmi numerals. As the pillars spread the emperor's edicts, these numerals would also spread with them throughout most of ancient India. In addition, as the centuries passed, these numerals would face significant changes. One of these changes would be the evolution from a system that relied on symbols with fixed values, including built-in powers of 10, to a positional numeral system, employing 10 as the base, that relied on 9 glyphs and a void, that could be used to represent a quantity that didn't exist, or to represent larger numbers of different orders of magnitude. Another significant change happened later, in 628 CE, with the addition of the glyph 0 by the Indian astronomer-mathematician Brahmagupta, which would replace the said void. This would be the first time in history where 0 would be defined and treated as a number in its own right. The sum of two positives is positive, of two negatives, negative, of a positive and a negative, the sum is their difference, if they are equal, it is 0. The sum of a negative and 0 is negative, that of a positive and 0 positive, and that of two zeros, 0. By this time, however, the numerals were already spreading to the Muslim world, where they would reach a Persian mathematician by the name of al-Khwarizmi, who, around 825 CE, would publish his book on the calculation with Hindu numerals. This work, describing the numerals, would eventually spread throughout the entire Muslim world. In the 10th century CE, these numerals would yet again suffer more changes, and they would split into two distinct variants, the Western Arabic numerals, commonly used in North Africa, and the Eastern Arabic numerals, commonly used in the Arabian Peninsula and Persia. From this point onwards, we shall focus on the Western Arabic numerals. During this era, North Africa was controlled by many Islamic dynasties, one of which would extend its domain to the northern shores of the Iberian Peninsula, the Umayyads. It would be there, in the Islamic Iberia, that these numerals, although without zero, would first be documented by Christendom in 976 CE, in a book by the name of Codex Vigilianus, a compilation of historical documents ranging from antiquity to the late 10th century Iberia. Around this time, a scholar by the name of Gerbert of Aurillac would travel to Spain and gain great fascination for all the knowledge the Muslims had, growing especially fond of mathematics and astronomy. Unsurprisingly, he ended up learning their numerals as well, which he avidly promoted when he was elected as Pope under the name Sylvester II by the end of the century. These numerals, however, would not gain as much popularity as one might expect. Anti-Muslim sentiment in Europe grew as the Crusades began in the following centuries, shielding Europe from many new Muslim ideas. A few centuries later, an author, now known to us as Fibonacci, would be born in the Italian Republic of Pisa. The son of a merchant, from an early age, he travelled with his father across the Mediterranean, meeting with many a merchant and learning about their systems of arithmetic. He soon realised the advantages of the Arabic numerals over the Roman numerals Europeans had been using for millennia. As such, he compiled a book describing this system and its uses, publishing it in 1202 by the name Liber Abaci. It would be in this book that the concept of zero would first enter Europe. With these 9 figures, and with the sign 0, which the Arabs call Zafir, any number whatsoever is written. However, these numerals didn't spread much outside of Italy, at least until the 15th century. Until this point, most of the documentation written in Arabic numerals was Pisan in origin, with Florence going so far as to ban the writing of zero and all other Arabic numerals in the 13th century. This was due in part to the fact that Arabic numerals, unlike Roman numerals, are fairly simple to forge, with one able to vastly increase the value of trade by many magnitudes with a simple addition of a single digit, a practice that was almost impossible using Roman numerals. In addition, the concept of zero made the business of granting loans simpler, a practice which was considered sinful to Christians as usury. However, this was about to change. With the start of the Renaissance, these numerals became more well known in the academic world, first throughout Italy, and then to the rest of Europe. Later on, with the invention of the printing press, these numerals became standardized and spread throughout Europe's masses, having replaced Roman numerals by the 16th century. Special thanks to our Imperator level patron, Fernando Lopez Ojeda. As always, thanks for watching. Be sure to like and subscribe for more great historical content, and feel free to check our Discord and Patreon, linked in the description below.